Sports. It's in the game.
We attacking, better stand back and watch. Send big blitz, nobody blocking. Big win, that's a ring and a watch. Strong in when he coming in a slot. Trying to bend the corner, your limbs getting. That's your partner, then your twin game. All you want to do is talk, I don't need to talk.
Gotta hurry, somebody talk.
I can pull up with that, Chewbacca that. Banging my chest and my head on the lock. Feeling like walking flock of flame. I put the opposition out the game. I'm out of pocket, but I rock with the game.
Only religion was the moon. Made a couple million, hallelujah. Daddy was a tutor. Called a homeschooler. Never did homework, I was gone home with the work, no tutor. Used to have enough. Grew up with the hustlers and the killers. Now I'm kicking it with Puffy in the villa. Chillin', click full of zombies like Thriller. Got real, about to get real. That's just how I'm feeling.
NFL on EA Sports as we are in the inner harbor of Baltimore at M&T Bank Stadium. The two teams emerging from their respective tunnels a minute ago to the approval of this Baltimore crowd. They're all set as their Ravens will match up with the Baltimore Ravens.
I played the game, I missed a shot. I had the answer, then forgot. I knew one day my pop finance for not, my not, my not. For lexing, I fell out and cut the check. My not, my not. For lies to set, but I've been taking hits like I can't die like any. Morning of the day, the dawn of the dead day. I don't see nothing but red. I gather the blankets and milk and the bread. I come from the east and I'm traveling west. Got a machete, I chop it. The nigga, the serpent, determined, the plot and the threats. It ain't no stopping a run. Popping son of God, dropping anybody who next. I want a mansion, I got a million advances. I'm gonna stay in Atlanta. Most of them move to LA and throw all of their money away and move back with their parents. I see the canvas, I got the brush in my hand. The colors are mixing again. Grabbing a stick with my hand, I drop my gush. The world is us, so what? Who wanna touch? Who wanna rough me up?
Nobody.
My head is ready to bust. Kicking the door when I come at the cut. Well, yeah. Who wanna touch? Who wanna rough me up?
Nobody.
My head is ready to bust. Do what I do and I say what I want. Well, yeah, mommy, your kid in the magazine, kid in the magazine. I had a stack on my jacket at Grammy. We see
from the site that many call the loudest in the NFL, we are inside GEHA Field at Arrowhead Stadium here in Kansas City. The scene just a few moments ago, predictably loud and raucous here at Arrowhead as their beloved Chiefs took field and they are set to match up with the Baltimore Ravens. Justin Tucker all set, and we are set to see the cream of the crop in the AFC as we are underway here with the Ravens and the Chiefs. And the opening kickoff will not be returned, as that will be a touchback. get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. That play going for 16 yards to start the drive. First down.
That's a very nice game there. A confidence-building run. Love the execution up front. And the way he pressed the hole, absolutely perfect.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Now Edwards-Helaire. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and 4.
All right, Brandon, I know we're in the early going here, but those kind of runs, they're going to open up a world of opportunities for this offense going forward.
The last run got 6, now second and 4. Now a carry for Edwards-Helaire. It'll go as a gain of 10 and a Kansas City first down.
They did tell us they wanted to establish the ground game early, didn't they?
They did, in a small sample size that we've seen so far, but pretty good return.
Yeah, you gotta like that. They've strung together a couple of first downs, established what they wanted, the running game. And guess what? They also got their lead guy running it pretty well, too.
On first and 10, here's Mahomes. This one complete to Mecole Hardman. And he's going to get this one down to the edge of the red zone. Good work after the catch. Going to net him 23 and a first. They'll run. It's Edwards-Helaire. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6. Edwards-Helaire as they run out of the gun. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. It's a 5-yard gain, but they'll still be a yard short here with 3rd down now looming.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. He'll take that any time you hand the ball to a back.
Edwards-Helaire, they'll try to run for it. And he will have the first down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. Give him 3 yards and a fresh set of downs. A terrific opening drive has them knocking on the door, first and goal. They go play action, now Mahomes. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked off by Deshaun Elliott. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. That right there is the inauspicious start that they were hoping to avoid, the turnover on the first possession.
I love how you use those college-bound words like that, inauspicious. Well done. I really appreciate that.
Thank you.
Here's the thing for me. I'm just wondering if their game plan is incorrect. You know, I think they felt like they could come in and throw it around pretty well. That interception early, they may rethink how they go about attacking.
And he gets this to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. Big yardage there on the scramble. It gets him a first down.
Oh, Lamar Jackson just so electric, Charles, when he gets into open space, and we saw Exhibit A right there.
You know something? I'm standing up here in the booth next to you watching the play. He buckled my ankles on that one as well. It doesn't matter whether you're actually on the field trying to chase him or you're just watching him play. This guy is sheer excitement.
And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line.
Boy, 30 more yards and another first down.
So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. Eluding the pressure right. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. He'll get 5 out of the scramble. It's 2nd down. We're scoreless after 1.
Nice pickup there. He gets about five down to the four-yard line.
Pretty good job defensively. Thought he was going to get it, but they knew where that marker was, and they stopped him just short of it.
What it does is emphasize that strategic football and situational football is not just played on the offensive side, is it? Defense understanding, as you noted, where the first down marker was and making sure they didn't get there.
They'll try to run for it with Dobbins. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Ravens touchdown. J.K. Dobbins taking it in from 4 yards out as his guys are first onto the scoreboard here this afternoon. Jackson here, he's going to look to throw. Escaping the pressure right.
I don't know about you, but I can't wait for a few years of two-point tries and see what the data tells us, because a lot of teams want to throw the ball in this situation, this time unsuccessfully. I just wonder if maybe running the ball might be the way to go.
With it moved up from the three to the two, you would think maybe a few more attempts at running.
I think stats over time may bear out that running the ball will at least be the equal of throwing it in that situation.
KC offense out of the huddle, ready for their next drive. And they had a nice little drive going last time through the interception in the red zone. Costly.
Bad enough to throw it anywhere, but that drives coaches insane when they're thinking about, hey, we got a shot at points already. We're already in a spot where you're thinking you've got three on the board for sure, and to come away with nothing, that's a really tough one for them to swallow.
Yeah. Will they make up for it?
A gain of four. It's now a second and six. At the 29-yard line.
Second and six, just inside the 30. A shotgun snap and a give to Edwards-Helaire. A pickup of about 3 yards as he's taken down at the 31.
Some of these play calls, I think they're a little conservative, but you know me, because it's easy to sit up in this booth, right, and make all the calls and think I'm going to be correct. But I would like to see them open things up, because otherwise this defense is going to gang up on.
And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Tavon Young.
That's right, baby.
And he will bring this back. It's a pick six and a Raven touchdown.
It goes without saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. That's a ball he would like to have back, and it lands right in the lap of the defender from there. He doesn't have very far to go before he gets to the end zone, and he got there in a hurry.
After the interception, here's Jackson, flushed out right. And he is into the end zone to bump the lead up two more. So their second touchdown of this first half. They went for two after score number one. Didn't get it. Now they get the equalizer, so to speak.
So to speak. And you can understand the thinking. Because they didn't get it after the first score, they wanted to get back to a normal points pattern, get up to 14. But just think, if they missed it here, they're only up 12 to nothing. One extra point on the other side could ultimately beat you if they score twice.
The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive, and they gave up the pick six, and now they'll be looking to right the ship here. Now, as a quarterback, are you a little more cautious this go around?
You should be, just because after what you gave up, but you can't be so cautious as to just really take things in, and now you're not going to play loose enough to give your team a chance to score. But you still have to be careful, because those defensive guys, I know the reputation defense guys can't catch. All evidence to the contrary on that last possession, though.
And Mahomes misfires again, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Marlon Humphrey. And he will bring this back. It's a pick six and a Raven touchdown.
Partner, what we just saw, that's a great example of a team that was really amped up. They've been playing so well, yet they didn't get overexcited and have a bust on defense and gave up a big play. Instead, they created their own big play with a pick six. This one may be over.
Yeah, it's just the first half, but that lead has swelled to the point where you're wondering if it is over already. And he'll get into the end zone as the two-point conversion is successful. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. Mecole Hardman to return it from his end zone.
At
KC offense out of the huddle, ready for their next drive. And they just had that pick six. I guess the only positive maybe of them returning that for a touchdown. This offense right back at. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Patrick Queen. And he will bring this back. It's a pick six and a Raven touchdown. And now the Ravens calling the offense onto the field here as they're going to go for two. Oh, this is becoming tough to watch. I don't know that I've seen three pick sixes from the same quarterback in the same game.
And I know that many are going to scream at the coach about why did you let him stay out there to throw those. But truthfully, what are the odds that you're going to throw three pick sixes in a game? You want to leave them out there so they can work through some of the rough stuff.
Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up first and 10 at their 25-yard line. Now Mahomes to try again after the pick six. Looking for Kelce on the deep ball. And this one is incomplete. Travis Kelce, the Pro Bowl tight end, the intended target. And now it's second down. Earlier in the quarter when the defense was keying on the run, you said offensively they need to open things up, take some shots downfield. Didn't work there, but they did it.
Yeah, I'm not going to change my tune now. I still think it's the right play because when you take those shots downfield, you open the eyes of the defense to what you could do to them, and that may open some things up for you offensively.
And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down. He was trying to get it to Tyreek Hill that time, and it's third down. Now Mahomes. Open man here, it's the tight end Kelce. And he's going to be out of bounds right at midfield. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
That's a big gainer on that play. And from experience, I can tell you, that's where defensive backs will come into the huddle and say, guys, how about some pass rush? But you're going to say it nicely because those big guys up front, they don't like being criticized very much. Quarterbacks in this league, you know they'll pick you apart if you give them time like that to find receivers downfield.
He'll take a shot for the end zone. Back of the end zone, could he get his feet down? No, it's incomplete. Mecole Hardman, the intended target, and that'll bring up second down.
I believe I'm following their logic. Take the big shot downfield, loosen things up. You're hoping to get some points on the board before the half. Maybe now you come back and throw some underneath stuff in order to make sure you get a completion.
Second and 10. From midfield, here's Mahomes. And it's incomplete.
Not only did he have a chance to scan the field there, it felt like he had a chance to scan it twice. The protection was that good. Unfortunately for him, the coverage downfield, equally good.
Throwing is Mahomes on third. They'll set up the screen to Edwards-Helaire. And he'll only get this to about the 44 as they stop him short of the line to gain. 5 yards, not enough. And it'll be fourth down. Mahomes and the offense staying out there. They'll go for it on fourth. Mahomes gonna go on fourth down. Complete, the tight end Kelce. And brought down, but able to get it to their 30-yard line. Fourth down, no problem. Just a ho-hum pickup of 14 to keep the offense on the field. On first down, Mahomes. And he's going to be taken down here. A sack back at the 32. Patrick Queen, he's the culprit, dropping him for a 2-yard loss. Behind the chain, second and 12. Another try after the first down sack. Mahomes taking a deep shot here for Hardman. And my goodness, another interception. It's Chuck Clark picking it off. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half. That is now 5 interceptions that he has thrown in this ball game. If I asked you to speculate what's possibly going on in his head, what would you say?
Well, if he's as mentally strong as I believe he is, he understands that not all these picks have been his fault. You know, some of the throws, yes, but there have been a good number of them where he hasn't been helped by his own receivers, and they've turned into interceptions. So he knows if he keeps firing, perhaps good things can happen, not just in this game, but especially in later ones.
So we've come to halftime after a very one-sided beginning to this one, as we are off to Orlando now to check in with Jonathan Coachman and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach? And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. The Ravens ready to receive it, and they've got the lead as well as we resume play in the second half. Devin Duvernay now returning from the end zone. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And the first half definitely went their way, and this would seem to be a great opportunity to kind of put this game a little closer out of reach with a score here.
Yeah, and it's a wonderful opportunity for them, because if they can add 7 more to their lead before the other guys even see the football, that could be the decisive blow in this game. I think that's how they're eyeing it. That's how they're approaching it.
Big yardage there on the scramble. It gets them a first down. They'll run with Dobbins. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop it right around the 1. A nice pickup of 6 there to get him closer to the end zone, and it'll be 2nd and goal. Dobbins once more. And he will take it in for a Ravens touchdown. J.K. Dobbins. His 2nd touchdown of the afternoon, and the Ravens add on. And he certainly played a pivotal role with those 2 TDs and why they're up on the scoreboard right now.
Well, someone's all about winning, aren't they? Because he's not worried about the numbers. Sure, it's great to have 2 touchdowns. But the bottom line is what he's doing is contributing to their lead. He wants to continue to do so.
And he'll get into the end zone as the 2-point conversion is successful. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. McCole Hardman to return it from his end zone. The Chiefs' offense about set to begin this drive. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And, of course, they'd like to forget the ending, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part 2.
Oh, wide open, complete. 20, 10, and all the way in for a Kansas City touchdown. I think you can make a fair case for Tyreek Hill being the most explosive player in the NFL when he gets his hands on the football, and that was Exhibit A.
Well, in this league where coordinators worry so much about drawing up the right routes, blocking assignments, misdirections and stuff, they have these precise arrows and movements. Sometimes the best plays just come from the schoolyard where you look at your fastest guy and say, go long, go get it, big man.
Mahomes will throw for it. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. So unable to throw it in for 2 from the 2. Let me ask you, as a former DB, what changes there around the goal line on a 2-point conversion as far as how you're defending it?
You just make sure you never back up and you never retreat. You establish yourself really on the line of scrimmage, put your heels on the goal line at worst. And if they're going to throw the ball, make them throw it over your head, because they're going to run out of space because of the back of the end zone. Never let a guy catch one in front of you.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And last time out, another touchdown. And I think there may be some empty seats around here by the time the 4th quarter comes around.
Yeah, I have to agree with you, because this one's just about decided. But you know who benefits from all those empty seats? You and me, trying to get to the airport.
That's
the road
true.
To be fairly
that,
clear
that is
by the time
positive.
We have to leave the booth.
Play action. It's Jackson. He's going deep for Brown. And got his man complete. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Ravens touchdown. For all the deserved accolades Lamar Jackson gets for his running prowess, you know, his deep ball, it's really a thing to behold as well. They'll try and throw for it. Flush to his right. And boy, talk about adding insult to injury. He's into the end zone to tack on two more. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. McCole Hardman to return it from his end zone. Hardman, he is not going to bring this out, so they will start the drive at the 25. KC offense out of the huddle, ready for their next drive. And last time, the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long pass. That maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up, whether it's on your grease board, right, in your playbook. One play drive's exactly what you want on offense. What they have to be careful of is not having a letdown. It was fairly easy last time. They can't expect that going forward.
And we'll see if it's that easy here. They'll break the huddle, come up on second and eight at the 27-yard line. Mahomes now to throw. Now he steps away. And I think the ball's out. And it's picked up by the Ravens. And some space here. And he brings it back to right around the 26-yard line. A disappointing end of the sequence there. He was starting to turn nothing into something, and then he lost the football.
And sometimes things get lost in the transition. And what I mean by that is you go from being a passer to a runner. And at a certain point, once you cross the line of scrimmage, you're strictly a runner now. There's no more downfield threat. Make sure you take care of the football while you're...
Jackson hit, and he lost the football. But this will fortunately wind up out of bounds. Can almost see inside his face mask there, the look of relief. He coughed it up, but it goes out of bounds. They keep it.
Someone carrying around the lucky horseshoe, aren't they? If I were him, I'd go out and play the lottery after that one. A very fortunate man.
And they're operating in plus territory here. They're thinking points. Definitely don't want to lose the football at this juncture. Jackson running again. And they corral him just a couple yards shy of the end zone. Really good effort. He does it himself, picks up 15, also picks up the first down. They'll look to run with Edwards. And he is into the end zone for a Baltimore touchdown. Gus Edwards taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Ravens have used the short field to their advantage as they cash in for six. John Harbaugh thought about it, and now his guys are going to go for the two-point conversion. They'll look to throw. Just keeping the play alive. And they're just not going to let up as he is into the end zone here for two more. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. McCole Hardman to return it from his end zone. Hardman will elect not to bring this out. And the football will be on the 25-yard line. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. And last time, not only the turnover, but that turned into 6 points. They got to make up for that here.
We always hear about empty possessions, but some are worse than others. You can have an empty possession, pump the ball away, get yourself set to play defense. But when you turn it over, it changes momentum. And when they take it downfield and punch it in on you, that's a bad possession all the way around.
Yeah, but you're hungry to get back out there, aren't you?
You better be, because otherwise, it's going to be a long day for you.
To the sideline, and it's caught, but boy, he's out of bounds. And they try to get him into space coming out of the backfield, but it'll be third down. Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. To throw, it's Mahomes. Oh, Mahomes can't get away, and down he goes.
Mahomes.
Patrick Queen picks up his second sack of the afternoon.
It's been a tough one all game long for this offensive line. They're already down big, and now you know they're just going to come after the quarterback in a big way, don't you?
Yeah, that O-line, they just can't get out of their own way right now. It's created an avalanche, and an avalanche is coming right on top of them. Team couldn't get ready in time, and this is going to be a delay. That's going to set him back 5 yards. So 4th and 15, but the offense is staying out there to go for it. They're indeed going for it as they look to throw. Eluding the pressure. Mahomes hit. He lost the football. And it's picked up by the Ravens. And this is going to be brought back for a Baltimore touchdown. We know this defense has some playmakers. We saw it right there. Well, really, we've seen it the whole game.
Isn't it nice to see that on the opposite side of the ball? Respect, my man. Respect. The defensive guys are outscoring their opposing offense.
Yeah, they're outscoring him indeed with that score alone. And now again, the play clock's going to run out on him. So that'll back him up 5. The defense more than did its job. Now the offense is summoned onto the field as they'll go for 2. Jackson from the shotgun. He's going to be taken down. It's a sack, and they fail on the try for 2. So here's the kickoff now as he'll get it again following that fumble return for a score. McCole Hardman to return it from his end zone. KC offense out of the huddle, ready for their next drive. And they weren't on the sidelines for long, but I'll tell you what, I'm glad you and I weren't down there. We could hear them, the coaches from all the way up here. They were adamant, you've got to hold on to the football or else we have no hope.
Yeah, it's easy for me to laugh sitting up here, but you're exactly right. If we were down there, that message would have been received a whole different way. Because turnovers, they've been a big problem for them. Got to take care of the football. Got to hold on to it.
Second down, back to Edwards-Helaire. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. 58 yards rushing for him now in the ballgame. I was pretty surprised there when they lined up to run it on second and long, but it worked out for him.
It certainly did, and that requires some confidence, some fortitude, and a little bit of hope, doesn't it? You hope you catch the defense just right and break off a big run to help yourself out on the next down.
No gain there on the play, and that's going to leave him with a 4th down.
Tight end to the right, boys. Tight end to the right. Move. 3 down, 3 down. 40's the mic, 40's the mic. There's Mike.
And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. No reason not to try it there, and they do indeed convert on 4th.
First down. First and 10 at the 47-yard line.
And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first. Boy, an effective play there, getting their wideouts involved in the run game.
And what they're always hoping on that type of a play, that they can get to the end of the line and have a chance to turn it upfield as he did there. That means they controlled the blocking and took care of the defensive end or the outside linebacker to give him that lane.
And I guess I need to clarify, I said getting their wideouts involved in the run game, but of course that was actually a pass as he popped it forward. Options galore here, second and a few inches. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 and mark him at the 5. Call that a very strong gain of 24. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So the Chiefs in possession of the ball as we welcome you back. They've got it first and goal as they look to punch in a late score. Kelce, the intended receiver there, but it'll be second and goal.
A lot can go wrong when you call a play like this down in the red zone, but that's where you appreciate this from your head coach. He's not afraid to trust his guys to do the right thing, and as a player, that means an awful lot.
And he's going to be shoved back short of the goal line.
Has a nice job there defensively, being able to diagnose that little touch pass. They saw it coming, converged on it before he could get much out of it.
Third and goal, trying to make that scoreboard at least a little more respectable. Looking to throw is Mahomes. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And somewhat of a measure of revenge as he's in for the touchdown, but they still trail big time.
He'll take it, but he won't be able to smile about it.
There was no going through the progressions on that touchdown pass.
Yeah, nor was it necessary. His receiver won that route early, presented himself. No reason to wait. Go ahead and put it on him and score a touchdown.
And he is not going to make it to the end zone. And that's pretty reflective of their game as a whole, as they'll remain down by a bundle.
Well, partner, since this new two-point rule came into play, offenses spend a lot more time working on it. That means the defenses are doing the exact same thing.
Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. Devin Duvernay now returning from the end zone. And he'll be dropped at the 21-yard line, so bringing it out of the end zone proves not a good decision, loses him about 4 yards. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive, and a few kneel downs should just about do it. Now, defensively, they do have all three timeouts, but very little reason to use them at this point. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and 8. Another run here with Dobbins. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down. Jackson on the give to Dobbins. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. Now the Ravens going to use one of their timeouts. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. A good gain on first, has him set up with second and just a couple of inches now from the 29. Jackson, he's going to keep it himself. And that could be a killer. He'll lose yardage and tackled inbounds. The Ravens going to use the second of their timeouts. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Jackson looking to throw on third. He's going deep for Brown. Got a man, it's caught inside the 10. And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly.
Well, this is long since over, and some might see this as overkill, but remember, this is a team that puts on the hard hats, grabs the lunch pail, and tells everyone, we're going to give you a full 60 minutes. And that's exactly how they're playing this one out.
And he'll get into the end zone as the two-point conversion is successful. And the Chiefs are going to make the recovery. Well, fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of an anecdotal type of a number. Kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
A big offensive explosion helped leading them to victory. And the defensive guys, they're just saying, hey, put those points up every week. We'll just keep winning.
They will gratefully accept them, won't they? It makes their job that much easier when they're scoring that many points, allows them to play with a totally different style and a different flow.